Assalamu alaikum, I am Adil Amjad and this is video lecture number 2. Today we are going to continue our previous topic, which is fundamental of computer. In last topic, we were discussed about computer, its basic definition, then we fetch data information and processing, little bit understanding of the abacus. If you were not watched the previous lecture, so I recommended you to first check out the first lecture and then proceed it. After covering this topic, you are able to define the structure and working of the abacus, Napier's bonds, Pascal line, and difference integral. Your today's resource is page number 9 and page number 10. The book link is already provided you in the previous lecture. So let's proceed. Evolution of computer. Evolution means research and improvisation in any field. How computer technology improved itself from dark age to middle dark age and then our latest modern age of computers. So the first age of computer is a mechanical age or a dark age. In this age of computer, all the machines are working by the hand, no electricity provided to the machine, they are slow in processing and perform some specific tasks. Then as we proceed further, we see electromechanical machines, electricity involved to operate the machines, and these are a fast machine as compared to a mechanical machines. Last but not the least is the digital electronic machines, these type of latest machines which we are using nowadays. Let's start with the abacus. Abacus is the first machine generally used for the counting and some basic calculations like addition, subtraction, or multiplication. Abacus invented in 3000 BCE by Chinese. So more than 5000 years ago, abacus is invented. Let's talk about the structure of the abacus. This is how abacus looked like. A wooden frame with number of beads, these are the beads, number of beads, some parallel rod, one and each other, and one horizontal rod. So far this abacus is counting a zero number because beads are not shifted, these are not shuffled, these are in their original positions. So this first column is just able to read a 9 number, 0 to 9 unit. This is tens, hundred, thousand, and so on. Let's check it out how abacus operate. Look at that here. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this one is 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80, 90, and this 100, 500. Okay, this is all for abacus. Next one is Napier's bonds. John Napier, a Scottish mathematician. This is the first machine which is able to calculate all the arithmetic operations. Multiplication, division, taking the square root. 1614, a Scotland mathematician invented a machine which is known as a Napier's bond. Very famous machine because of the invention of logarithm. Logarithm you are studied in mathematics. Inshallah, chapter number 3 is based on the mathematics of logarithm. So John Napier was the first person who invented logarithm. This is Napier's bonds table. Look at that, these are the tables, number of rods, and calculation can be done by using the special techniques of multiplication, division, etc. So this is the Napier's bonds calculation table for which we are able to perform all the mathematical operations within a no time. This is a very fast machine on that era. If you check it out, this machine, this is only a table generated machine. 2, 4, 6, 8, 2 5s are 10, 2 6s are 12, 17, 18, 16, 18. Similarly, on the vertical side, 2 4, 6, 8, 10, 12, 14, 16, 18. Now, if we have one problem to calculate 34 multiplied by 8 with the Napier's rods, so we not need all these rods. We are hide it here and just leave 34 and 8 column. Just leave the 34 and 8 column. We need this portion to calculate 34 into 8. This is our blocks which calculate 34 into 8. Just you need to perform a diagonal operation here. Here you see 2 is first number which we displace it here, so 2. Then a diagonal operation on 4 and 3, add 4 with 3, so 4 plus 3 is 7, and the last one is 2, so write it 2 here. So this is the result of 34 multiplied by 8 with Napier's rods. Just try to operate the operations in the diagonal forms, 2, and then add the second diagonal entities, 3 into 4, and just write a 2. Because in this block, we are seeing here, 2 is not sum up with any other number, 4 and 3 is sum up, and just leave it with 2. So this is the last result with the Napier's rods, 34 into 8. So that is how Napier's rods is working. Napier's table is working, very interesting, and all the operations are performing like that. Our next topic is Pascaline. So far we read about the abacus, Napier's rods, and third one is Pascaline. What is Pascaline? How is it made? Let's see it here. Blaise Pascal, a French mathematician, just at the age of 19, he invented a Pascal line. Now, Pascal line is the first electromechanical machine. This is not based on the mechanical machine. This is a electromechanical machine, and this is much faster than Napier's rods and the previous one, abacus. This is how Pascal line look like. This is a dial with a gear option to rotate the dial. Each dial has a number of 1 to 9. So we have a 5 dials here, and each dial is connected with the digital slots. These are the slots. When we rotate the dial here, number is displaying on the these slots. Let's check it out how this works. If we read a 28, so first we read 2 here and then rotate the dial till we are not proceed to 8. This is how we read any number. So this is all for today. In next lecture we will inshallah discuss the difference function in detail with Hodrick test, slide rule and other. So this is your home assignment. Try to solve it as soon as possible and send it to me on AIS or your comment section where you viewing this video. So you have to do write the name of inventor, like abacus invented by a Chinese. Its time of invention is 3000 BCE. Its operation structures. So solve this similar for the Napier's rods, Pascal line. At this time skip difference engine. We will discuss it on next video. So this is all for today. If you have any query, comment on your Facebook page. I will review it and answer it as soon as possible. So thank you for today. Allah Hafiz.